I remember the moment I discovered that he died. My heart was crushed. My body crumbled as I cried. With one word resounding in my mind. Why? This didn't make sense. And I didn't understand. You see, from childhood to maturity, our innocence, it falls apart as we face the reality that life is hard. Life is full of tragedy and sorrow, of suffering and trials. And while we're in the midst of processing the pain, what do? Who do we turn to? Where do we go? Many don't know, and so we're left hurting, empty, alone, wondering why for the rest of our lives, as if an answer to that question would truly satisfy, as if it would change the pain. And so the truth remains that we don't know, and we won't know, and we'll never know why. We have to face the facts. But in the midst of that, what if there were a better question to ask? Is there hope? Come on. You see, it's a question we should consider, because how we answer changes how we live. You see, a wise man once said, without hope, the heart is sick. You see, without hope, we are driven to depression and despair. Without hope, we reach a point where we just don't care. So, is there hope? Maybe you're uncertain, but you see, it's a question worth searching. I mean, if we live in a universe without purpose that transcends, then we are nothing more than cosmic accidents. We're just matter, so nothing really matters in the end. There's no hope. But is that true? Or do we live in a world with design and intention? We have to wrestle with the question, is there hope? Right. Different worldviews give different answers. But what answer stands out from the rest? What answer is best? You have to make your own conclusion, but I believe that the answer is yes, there is hope, and here is why. God stepped into the midst of human suffering. He came to us in the person of Jesus and experienced what it meant to be fully human. The good, the bad, and the ugly. In the midst of loss, he experienced grief and he wept. He suffered on the cross and he experienced the pain of death. His resurrection gives us hope for this life and the next. And even after he left, he sent us his Spirit to lead us and to guide us, to teach us and to remind us that he is always present. And so we will never be alone. Oh, there is hope. And this hope, it is an anchor to my soul. In life's storms, it is a hope I tightly hold. It is a hope that you can have. It is a hope that you can know.